Welcome to Pro Se Legal School. I'm Coach Davis, and today we're going to talk about what happens when you do a chargeback against Coach Neighbors after you download his stuff and try to get away with stealing his shit. That's kind of what we're going to talk about today. So I don't know. I'm just going to show you guys some information and let you check it out. And know anybody who does a chargeback against me that hasn't called me and told me they didn't get the stuff or whatever, then this is where they're going to be. Oh, wait. Anybody that has a chargeback anyway. I sell digital products and I don't offer a chargeback, particularly after you know. So I'm going to show you guys some facts for Mr. Frank Vitale, and you guys can decide what you think. You guys can leave me a comment in the comment section when I get done with this presentation if you think Mr. Frank Vitale is guilty of trying to steal from me. Let's get started. Going to do a screen share. Okay, so we're going to screen share some information about Mr. Frank Vitale. And I don't offer a chargeback on my stuff for obvious reasons. Mr. Frank Vitale is Mr. Frank Vitale doing a chargeback to rip me off? I don't know. I'm just going to show you the facts I want you guys. He told PayPal that he did not receive the product. Is Mr. Vitale stealing from my business? If he received the files, how many times did he download it? Did Mr. Vitale call me on the day that he purchased the document and he did not receive the files? I mean, I don't know. These are all questions that I would think that PayPal would be asking before they just, did Mr. Vitale receive the digital lawsuit package he needed to save his property from foreclosure? It's pretty sad when you have a business and you're offering way less than what you can stop the foreclosure on your house with a premium package that's half price at $1,500. Keep your family from getting thrown down in the street, and then a month and a couple of days later, go back and lie to the insurance, credit card company that you didn't receive and you didn't receive it. You haven't called me or nothing. I think most people spend $1,500 if they don't get their shit on and within a few minutes. They're on the phone, and I would be too. I would be there no way in hell that I would have $1,500 out of my thing and not, that's just me. Mr. Vitale must have a lot of money because, you know, he didn't miss that $1,500. He didn't do shit about it for 30 days. So I'm going to show you some facts, and I want you guys to decide if Mr. Frank Vitale's lying ass is telling the truth. Yeah, I'm calling you a liar, Frank. Now, Frank Vitale informed my professional business partners, my financial business partners, that I scammed him out of $1,500, and he never received the product. And I suffer professional defamation from Mr. Frank Vitale's RICO fraud scheme. Because these people trust me and they take my customers, whatever, so they think I'm stealing from my customers, I don't think they're going to want to keep me on their platform for very long. So, you know, okay, this is their problem. This is their problem anyway. Okay, this is their problem anyway, because I want to send a clear message to other assholes who think that they can, get some shit on the internet, you know, because they're smarter than everybody else, and then come back and take the money back after you used, I don't know if he downloaded the file or not. We'll talk about that in a minute. So the fact that he lied to my financial business partners is a personal attack on my business and my right to contract. It appears to me that Mr. Frank Vitale is involved in a RICO operation where he scams small business owners with his credit card fraud bullshit, and then after he gets receives their products or services, then he calls his credit card company and tells them, we'll see. Mr. Frank Vitale, you know that RICO, or if you don't know, you know now, that RICO has a private right of action. Now, I don't know, you're a pretty smart guy, I guess, so you're smarter than me since you're going to come try to take my shit. What that means is that a private individual can go after a private individual for RICO. Uh-huh. That's what that means. So if you're using your credit card and you're buying my stuff, and then you're calling your credit card company and lying to them that you didn't receive the shit, and you did, and you downloaded it 13 times or whatever, and then you get your money back. That's RICO. That's, how many times have you done that? How many times have you done that to people? Looks like RICO to me. I'm studying that, and I do know that RICO has a private right of action, so I can come after you just in your own individual capacity, which is what I plan to do, because all that corporation shit is ridiculous, okay? If PayPal's not contacted ASAP in the next, and this bullshit cleared up, I'll be filing the claim. But see, here's the thing. I already know that your insurance company, I spend a little time doing my homework, is no longer, it's closed permanently. But I do know that the reason that it's closed is because InZone Insurance Services acquired your business. So those are your business partners. I wonder how they're going to feel when they find out the shit you're pulling on me. Because, yeah, I'm going to. I'm going to send them the video when I'm done here. And they're going to need to know. Because part of the damages that I'm claiming against your ass for professional defamation and for, it's going to be that your interest in their business. Because I'm thinking they're going to want to have someone that's way more honest as a partner. Oh, funny how it goes. When you know how to sue people, then you can do different things. You don't have to take people's shit just because they don't think you have any money or just because they took your money. Okay, so this first screenshot that I'm going to share with you guys is a screenshot. Okay, so here, the first thing I want to share with you guys is a screenshot. And remember, I want you guys to leave me a comment and let me know what you think about this, if you think that this man's trying to steal my service. This is a screenshot showing password changed for user Frank Vitale. Now, this password change means that he had already set up an account. The CEO of website design and marketing, she set up our website. So you have to, like, log in, and you have to have an account to be able to access your documents. You have to have an account to be able to, and boy, that really, I didn't realize how important that was until. So right here, he's logging in, and this is letting us know that the password changed for Frank Vitale, for Frank.Vitale. And so in order to get this password stuff set up or whatever, you have to be able to prove that you. You have to be able to provide your address. You have to be able to provide your zip code number. You have to provide your email address, your phone number. There's about seven. I've only went over the first four or five. There's about seven. Without one of those things, your cell's not going through. So this is the way to verify who's doing what. So this is the first part of this. Now, that shows that he set up an account and he logged in to change password so he can, and it appears so he can do some dirty shit, or at least try. But, dude's older than me. So now this one here, this shows all the information here that we needed to have. It shows the email address and the phone number. And email address and phone number, we'll show you some other information later. Just remember I circled these. right here, let me see if I can blow that up a little bit so you can. Right here says that he downloaded the package 13 times. And that's a reflection of someone older who don't really understand how this works, because you can't download. You have to personalize the documents while they're on it, while they're on the computer, and then you have to download them. And not only that, if you don't have an account, then you're not going to be able to access the documents. If you don't have an account set up, you know, so, yeah, 13 times. And it really didn't need to do that. But, you know, and I just want to throw it out there because I just want to throw it out there because I can throw it out there. Right here, revoke access. I can revoke access to any files that sold off from my website. All I had to do is hit that button right there and then scroll over here, up down here to update and update that puppy dog. And then all of the files that you got, even though you printed them off or whatever, whatever, you're not going to be there. It's just going to be gone. you know, it's sad that you got to have this kind of shit, but, you know, we have it to protect ourselves and other people. Okay? Because if people are able to get someone else's credit card and use it, and you know, can't get through the, you know, can use it and get through the, well, then I'm getting jacked, they're getting jacked, and the system, yeah. So we have protocols set up to help stop this problem. Well, excuse me, it can't stop it, but we can sure show here that that somebody's full of shit. And it's not us. This shows the order. There you go. On April 4th, the following order came from Frank Vitale. And remember, we have all of the information right there. Maybe someone's using all of his information or something. I don't know. Well, we'll take a look at that. Right now, it looks like Mr. Vitale paid for this lawsuit package. That's a $3,500 package already on sale for half price. This lawsuit package addresses not only the 42 USC 1983 foreclosure issue because they're violating your due process, statutes and codes are not valid laws. It also addresses the mortgage fraud, the path that the mortgage, that the loan took after you left the table. For instance, in the mortgage fraud package, where there are six things that's missing from that lawsuit that you're claiming is, was filed in court against you by the attorneys. And one of the six things that's missing is you're claiming that the lender agreed to do the deal according to the Gap County principles. Oh, that's one of the six things. That's one of them. And the lender can't say they did because they didn't. They can't say they didn't because they'd be admitting, the lender's not involved in it. When it gets to the lawsuit, when it gets to the foreclosure part, the lender's not involved. It's third-party debt collecting attorneys trying to steal your shit. Uh-huh. So that lawsuit package is very valuable, and I'm sure Frank used it. He reported this. He bought this in April 2024, and I got the email yesterday on PayPal that they're jamming at my account to take to freeze my $1,500 that he spent, that was spent back on April 24th. So y'all ask now what that shit does to your bank account, okay? And no, he hasn't contacted me to tell me there was any kind of damn problem. Hell no, Frank ain't contacted me for shit. So here we are. So let's just, so right here, I did a search of the phone number that's on the invoice that Frank used. And there's that number belonged to these four potential owners. and two of them are the same. So I don't know. That's. But you know, it gets even more interesting than that. Here we did a people looker search of Frank, and you know, we found him in Soquel, California. So right here, there's Mr. Francis Vitale, Frankie Vitale, and six more names. So these are all aliases, and this is address, email. Oh, look at 14 emails. Whoa. Look at all of those email addresses. Oh, and so some of these look like similar to mine. That was missing a number. Yep, this one is similar. The front is different, but there's a number. Oh, huh. I don't know why Frankie would need so many. We need so many email addresses here that are connected to his name. Mm-hmm. Looks like a recall situation to me. I don't know. I don't know. I need y'all to tell me. Yeah, there's his address, his property. So we're going to be adding his property. When I did the lawsuit, we'll find a lien against his property. So we got a little more research to do on that. All of those emails. Huh. Wonder why you need to have so many emails. He's got a few phone numbers too there. 15 emails. Six phone numbers. We checked in for criminal. There was nothing in there. We did do a Google search of his name, and we found out that his insurance company was closed up forever. So we found that was interesting. So we done some more search, and we found out that Endzone Insurance Service bought him out, and now he's partners with them. Oh, Endzone Insurance. And they're in the same, in the same town. Endzone Insurance. Wow. Look at there. Oh, there's the contact email. I wonder if they know that about Frank and how he's doing. Oh, so, Frank went out of his way to let my business partners know that I scammed him and they need to give him some money. So I think I need to let Frank's business partners know that he scammed me. And now I'm going to sue him for defamation. And part of my demand in the lawsuit is going to be for his part in their insurance company. I'm sure I don't know shit about insurance, but I can probably do a better job than his lying ass. Because I don't steal from people. I don't screw people. Oh, yeah, I help you save your house, and this is what I get. So maybe I'll put a lien against your house, too. Because I know you saved it. Yeah. There you go. Endzone Insurance. So I'm going to be communicating with them shortly and send them a copy of the video. Okay, so that's about it. So Frank, you can hit me up if you want. You can hit me up and apologize for this shit. And by the time you do that, your ass better had already called PayPal and fixed this problem. I've been doing business with PayPal for 40 years. I ain't never had nope. And we ain't gonna start now. I see where this is headed. So I want to make it clear to others who think they can screw me over by investing in my stuff, then lying your ass on the backside. Okay, this is what's gonna happen. I'm gonna video record this shit. I'm gonna put all your information right there. And then I'm going to contact your business partner that you do business with and let you see how that shit feels. So bring it if you wanna take my shit without paying.